3.
Dus ja, we zitten nu, onze lichaam was meegenomen hier naartoe. We zitten in onze geheugen. To be is hier. En eens kijk, to be. To be.
Nice, to be, let's go and fuck now. Cyber 6 is amazing.
Let's make hot fuck. Dus ik dacht gewoon aan. Want ik heb deze fetish waar je deze like deer, like fucking head hoornen aandoet en dan like een orgasme doet op stream. Is dat een geweldig idee? Huh? Is dat geen goed idee? Kom op. Doe het.
Je hebt het toch niet gezien, hè?
No, fuck V. Ja, maar toch. Fuck V.
Waarom oh, je hebt dat... het gezien.
Hij heeft me dat twee keer laten zien. Wat een asshole. Dus ja, deze baas is niet zo moeilijk eigenlijk. In feite, ik maak een grap van deze baas op dit punt. Ik heb zoiets van, what the fuck, waarom was ik zo bang voor dit ding?
Makes me really wonder why, how you have verloren. But...
En even gewoon, ik dacht van, oh ja, dit is makkelijk, laat ik hem wel even aanvallen. En toen gooide hij mij. En hij vermoordde me in één shot. Like, he one-shot at me.
Ja.
Ik bedoel, ik deed natuurlijk veel minder schade en ik kreeg veel meer schade, want ik had niet de juiste chipset op, maar ja. Nou ben ik letterlijk god.
Zes, je vraagt nog steeds in heel veel, ik weet ook niet. What the fucking Twitch ambassador is. Nee, zit je zeker? De Twitch ambassador zit erin.
You are killing the Twitch ambassador!
No, keep doing that. Fucking deer orgasms, never fucking forget.
Ja, like, bijna is het een beetje gek geworden. Een beetje doorgedraaid. Je kan zeggen dat er een schroefje los is. Hè? Schroefje, snap je waar wij zijn in.
Ja, ik snap het.
Jullie hebben net het al gedaan, gaan we over naar 2.
Nog een achievement, come on!
Twing! Achievement, get up! Yes, getting kind of fucked. Zeg ze wel, maar ze doet er nooit wat aan. Weet je, like, ik vind wel de pot 153 nooit uitlegt over wat er is gebeurd met 2B. Wat 2 eigenlijk heeft gedaan. Wat E2 eigenlijk heeft gedaan.
Want pot vindt het leuk.
Ja. Als je afvraagt wat dat is, dat is like 2A's best, like E2's beste vriend, D2. Hè, snap je hem? Ennis? E2, D2.
Hilarisch, ja.
Weet je wel, morgen, like, ochtend is het niet juist middag of avond.
Het is daglicht. En dat is zo simpel als het gaat.
Het is altijd daglicht hier!
Exactly.
Maar wij weten ook niet zeker of het zomertijd is of wintertijd.
Daglicht, we laten op dat.
Het is altijd daglicht hier!
Nee, exact. Er is geen tijd meer in deze wereld.
Je moeder heeft geen tijd meer. Oké, ik ga dit zo gelijk zeggen. De looping animatie van E2 is geweldig gewoon voor de fucking, like, butt shake. It is very enticing. Also, E2 kan, wat is de naam van techniek in Bleach? Flash step. Nee, die streep die ze maakt is niet dat ze zo snel gaat dat ze een streep achterlaat. Nee, dat is blijkbaar gewoon, I don't know, hete olie of zo dat ze achterlaat. Of dat is nog steeds on a period, and we don't know.
Oh, then she's always on a period.
I mean, ze verdraagt zich soms natuurlijk zo niet.
Ja.
Emil, it's get like... the fuck over your bastard!
Dit is zo'n beetje de run of angry androids. A2 is ook soms erg like angry for no reason.
En wie voor een heel andere reden, like, geeft hem steeds hier materialen in plaats van fucking chips. Daar heeft hij wel chips. Toen ik als 9S speelde, geeft hij me de hele tijd fucking materialen terwijl ik chips wilde hebben. En hij zat eigenlijk op dezelfde plek ook, wat fucking raar is. Als zijn inventory, like, de plek wordt te bepalen als zijn inventory is, maar voor een of andere reden, like, doet het gewoon niet normaal.
Had je like een hard reset gedaan of gewoon een load save?
Ik heb alles gedaan. Een hard reset, een soft reset, een load save, alles.
Eto is ook een van de bijzondere robots met like... Androids met haar eigen provoke skill, dat ze waarvoor ze niks hoeft te equippen.
Ja. Nou, eigenlijk kan provoke met andere klokjes ook, maar het is gewoon. Waarom zou je het doen zonder chip? En dus kan provoke zwaar wild zo.
Ja, het is like, ik heb toch niks te verliezen. Alles is one hit kill.
Alles is one hit kill. Dat was geen Goliath, zo. Waar fuck komt dit ding vandaan?
Hadden we nou maar 9S, awesome. Ik kon nu weer de achtergrond verhaal van deze robot vertellen.
Awesome was fuck team though. Hekel.
Oh nee, ze zitten biljart te spelen. Met lasers en ballen en kanon en cool bullets.
Met al deze ballen uitschakelen om Hegel te verslaan. Hegel.
Dit is waarom een bullet time
Hegel
plus bullet heb
je. En het is Hegel. Dit is wel seksistisch.
Alright.
Dus, en dit is, like... Ik had dat zo blopt. Heeft ze keihard
ken. Berserk mode.
Ja, keihard ken. Alles doet wat meer schade, maar jij doet veel meer schade dan wat dan ook.
Tenzij hij invincible gaat.
Ja. Is het ding dat ik probeer het uit te zetten, maar je kan het niet uitzetten. Ik gebruik het nooit, want waarom zou ik? Ik doe al veel schade.
Oh, if you want to do more.
Nou, denk ik.
En dat is al het exchange, hè? Het is like safety versus more.
Ja, dus we gaan, dat is de enige keer wanneer we echt een keihard kern gaan gebruiken.
Ja, fantastisch, hebben we ook de fucking invisible wall gevonden.
Een invisible sensor wall. Het is de enige keer dat deze team speelt ook.
Er zijn vele baas teams, wel in hier dat alleen maar één keer speelt.
Nee, eigenlijk
like niet.
Grappig genoeg niet. A Beautiful Song wordt later ook afgespeeld als een instrumental later.
Ja, ja.
Ja. Ja, Shell 2, stupid.
Nee, ik was net klaar met Nines.
Ja toch? Fuck me. We zijn in de geheugensysteem bij de WG. Dit is waarom we wat dingen gaan zien.
Ik heb toevallig, volgens mij was het like A2's. Stemacteur is toevallig dezelfde stemacteur als like een van de hoofdkarakters in Dragon Card 3.
Ja.
Van wat ik herinner door te horen. En dat is in het Engels. Just so you know. En is like beide in like Dragon Card 3 en in like Neo Tenma. De Engelse versie klinkt altijd als een bitch.
Yes, so, yeah. Zee, you're a fucking idiot. Als je wat metal erbij doet, dan klinkt deze team als het Doom Eternal team.
Really no.
Wanneer je like aan het like in like niet gevecht bent. Hoor je like demon demonic chanting all the time. Dat klinkt als Donald Duck die aan het zingen is.
Ja. Waarom de fuck krijgen we 2B's geheugens erbij?
Omdat we 2B's ja, geheugen heeft gegeven in de zwaard.
Ah, ik guess it makes
lies! And deceit! Urusai! Shut up! Shut up!
I want to know every single detail of you. Now give me already your fucking sizes.
3 sizes. Ik kan gewoon naar mijn fucking modelnummer gaan, dumbass.
No, I want to hear it from you.
Yeah, showed you scent.
Well, you are the same though. You all look the same.
We all look the same. We might as well be the same person. Ja, dat is het einde van chapter 12. Dat was snel.
Damn.
Like de hoofdverhalen in dit spel zijn eigenlijk best wel gaan zo snel voorbij nu. Want er zijn geen nieuwe gebieden om naartoe te gaan. We hebben alleen maar bazen nu op dit punt. En er zijn de torens, maar de torens zijn nog kleine dungeons maar. Monitor, toe, we hebben geen keuze meer. Dat is een beetje het verhaal gaat of niet soms? Geen keuze.
Nee.
Ik weet dat A2's memory is in compared to 2B's data. Currently monitoring progress it to analyze effect. Hold, but, as you detected in your conversational function, numerous machine lifeforms, okay, oh, calm down.
Was that a nice nap, you deserter?
Shut the fuck up. Ah, yes, the obvious. Now shut up. Ik vind het leuk hoe je deze toren van elke plek kan zien, though. Anyway, this toren is so fucking cool. is gewoon jammer dat ik daar een Pokémon gevecht in moet houden. Fuck my life.
Obviously, dat is het eerste ding wat Jesse aan denkt. Dus waar kan ik er in een Pokémon gevecht houden?
Ja, dus het lijkt op de fucking Colosseum in Pokémon Colosseum. Like de laatste Colosseum.
I know.
Misschien is er een referentie naar iets.
Ik word daar dus eigenlijk een grote fan van Pokémon Colosseum in. It's that fucking simple.
Yes. Ik zie hem niet als een Pokémon spelen, though. Ga niet genoeg mensen...
Joke ending!
Er is een joke ending. Destroy Pesco.
Stop trying to hit me and hit me already.
Okay, he died, I think. And you too, destroyed Pascal. Pascal's death led to the collapse of the city and its residents going out of control, resulting in the elimination of all androids on Earth. Jeez.
Woo! Amazing.
Overzealous.
ありがとうございました。貴様も機械生命体だろう。いいえ、あなたと戦うつもりはありません。私の名前はパスカル。戦いの機械生命体です。だからなんだ。機械生命体に魂なんかない。ただの殺戮機械で私の仲間を何人も殺した罪を。
Now I have to go now. My planet needs me.
Oh, if you say so. Number two, you're still alive? Sorry, I haven't been in touch on the Monet. You survived, that's all that matters. Though I fear that all of your fighting companions have died. I have to kill 21 with my own hands. 21? Did you know that you remember near name 2B that looked just like... She's dead. 2B is dead, I killed her. She was infected with the logic virus. Oh. Well, please, make yourself at home in our camp. What they say, our memories are contained in this sword. I see. You can go ahead and use her old womb then. I'm in charge of the camp here. Oh my dear, yeah, okay, whatever. Hey Anemona, I got a question for you. Any chance you could spare a fuel filter? A fuel filter? I'm afraid Pascal makes them for us so you could go pick them up. What? Pascal? You know him? Yeah, you trade with the enemy? His village is different. They've never caused us any harm. No way, forget it. This might be hard to understand. But the force in an alliance and trade materials when they are lead to hives. We can't be picky about how we reach our goals. Okay, yeah. Besides, we aren't forgotten to kill machine life for all the surrendered. You've changed, number two. The way you talk and act is completely different from how you were in the past. And you've become a true leader. I'm nothing compared to Rose. En nou gaan we haar achtergrondverhaal horen, want we hebben de computer hier. Actually,
nee, zo is zo.
Waar is de porn folder?
Je don't need je hebt de, je moet het gaan hacken met de pop. Hacking time. I need to know your intentions. Just hack already. I need to know your intentions.
Born!
You deserter. But I won't join along.
My name is Anemone. I lead the end of resistance. It is recorded experience losses. I have the machine life from attack lands far too close for comfort. I smell an acrid order and know that some of my hair has been synced off. Anemona, retreat for now, that's an order. That's my captain, Rose. I obey her without hesitation. Running from the front as soon as I take out a few nearby enemies. Feet flying beneath me. I leap into a hastily built trench where my resistance comrades are gathered. How many battles is this now? The same sights and sounds, the same struggle of attrition. My resistance forces play the same ball and repeat with no end in sight. I don't even remember why we're fighting anymore, but I must continue regardless. I must continue. This looks bad, Sean. What should we do? Aqua-chan, get the fuck out of my house, goddammit! You don't search for an opening, you make one. No, Aqua, that's fucking illegal, don't break into my house! I grab Dahlia's arm before she can flee the trench and turn to Rose. She brought us here after all. She must have a plan of some kind. But Aqua just blew everything up again, god damn it. Someone just started fighting over there, what? But that's not possible. We're all here. Margaret's right. There are only 9 of us left, capable of fighting these machines. Captain Rose, Gerbera, blah blah, Sonia, Erika, Margaret, Sion, Dahlia, and me, Anemone. That's the solid left. Eight distant forces. Yeah, it's like 200 years ago. Well, Jesus Christ. And then easy Sonia pulled the like, strand of hair, clothes, shoes, blah. I don't like it, she says. What if it's some kind of machine trap? I wait for a while, heart pounding, until I hear the enemy fire lessen. Okay, I say, this looks like our chance, let's pull back. Someone's fighting out there, Anemone, cries Dahlia. We can't abandon them. Oh, so you want to risk all of our lives for some stranger? Come on. We don't even know if this mystery fight is on our side or not. That's not what I said. Enough you two, barks Sion. The captain makes the final decision. After Sion speaks, all of us turn to Captain Rose. And he's like, he's also to speak. Gerbera, the enemy is heading towards the explosives we set up earlier, yes? Gerbera thinks for a moment. Now that you mention it, yes they are. A slight smile crosses Rose's face, yet she still seems perfectly composed. Good, then if this goes well, we might be able to take them all out. I want all of you to leave this trench and get to the explosives, says Rose. Ugh. We'll let the blast take out most of them, then clean up the stragglers. Identifying our unknown mystery fighters can wait until we're done. No one objects to Captain Rose's decision. The moment she issues the order, we all leave to the trench. When we reach the battle, we find that appears to another set of androids dressed in strange black outfits. They even know what's happening. We detonate explosives, kill the remaining machines, and turn our guns in their direction. Alright, I say to the stranger, start talking. Easy, says one of the mystery androids, we're on your side. We're new androids, both as a part of something called Project Yura. Really?
Yeah.
I say, we haven't heard anything about new models. I probably speak with more bluster than necessary, but I have to make sure they're actually on our side. I don't think they're lying necessarily, but I can't read their expressions thanks to the giant goggles they wear. And frankly, a little caution never goes amiss in middle war. We learned that the four androids refer to each other as number 2, number 4, number 16, and number 21. And they also aren't in a hurry to share much more. Our mission is top secret, and one of them says. That's why you haven't heard about us yet. I slowly draw my knife and attempt to gauge their reaction. So in other words, no one will know you any better if I kill you right now. Stand down, Anemone, says Rose softly. No, cries Lily, she's right. We've all seen how quickly the enemy is evolving. Who's to say these four aren't just machines that just look like human? That's impossible, that would never happen. later. One of the strangers, number 16 I believe, draws a long knife from its sheath. If it's a fight you want, she says, I'm happy to give it to you. Before I can respond, Dahlia leaps in front of me with her weapon at the ready. This is it, we're going to fight. But just before the battle can erupt, Edward called number 22 and said stop. There used to be 16 of us, says number 2, but the others died during the descent. We've isolated alone out here. But reinforcements aren't coming, and that means we have to finish the mission with the soldiers we have left. We don't need more enemies right now. What we need is allies. She finishes the speech with a soft sigh, as if trying to and failing to hold her emotions in check. I know that sort of a voice. It's a voice of someone who still has hope, despite all odds. Dat is hoe like A2 Anemone heeft ontmoet en shit. Zoals de eerste modellen van Yora.
Huh.
En nou is hier de logic virus, want de logic virus was een groot probleem vroeger. According to the Yora team, there's an enemy server beneath Mount Kaala. If we can take it out, we might finally gain some ground in this endless war. But in order for that to happen, we need to work together. After a bit of thought, Rose decides to throw in something. What are you doing, Dahlia? Just throw this idiot. How weak she is, replies the okay. Beats her opponent. Number 16, you're obviously outmatched. The two of them are taking turns hitting each other. It seems friendly enough as those things go. Plus, they've been doing it for so long now that both of them are out of energy. They likely couldn't punch a piece of paper at this point. The rest of the group stares at the combatants, trying twice not to grin. Talia number 16 seemed to butt heads over the smallest things, but maybe it's because they're both so much alike. It's almost annoying how quickly they're doubled now. The rest of us conversed as Talia and 16 continued to spar. We call each other by names that I gave us, explains Rose. I see, response number 4. I thought it strange that you didn't use code numbers. She nods while she speaks as though it all makes perfect sense. Suddenly Captain Rose breaks out into a wide grin. You know what, she says? I think we should give all of you names as well. No, says number 2. It would be a waste. Rose eyes are rarely a waste. You can name me when the mission is over, she replies as a blush rises in her cheeks. I could tell her words also served as a wish for success. Alright, responds Rose. I think of a name for you by then. She knows this is a fleeting promise, as much as most things are, but this doesn't matter. Already, I can see us growing closer to the Yora team. Well, my friends are growing closer to them, at least. You're all being careless, I state, much louder than I intend. Luckily, the others either don't hear or decide to ignore it. Don't get me wrong, I'm not about to go against the captain's judgment, but it doesn't mean I'm ready to just lie down and trust our new friends. Ours is a solitary existence that has long since been abandoned by the moon. No matter how they cried, mourned, or struggled, the voice of our departed comrades went unanswered. So how can you trust an entire squad of new models that you just met? What's wrong, Anemone? I hear Lily calling to me. She's likely concerned about being part of the rest of the group. Nothing. I'm fine. Before I can complete my thought, Lily suddenly opens her mouth and emits a terrible scream. Ah! Lily's scream echoes throughout the entire camp. It's heartbreaking. It's agony. It's horrible. She's infected, screams Rose. Lily's infected. We all draw weapons out of instinct as much as anything else, pointing them at our comrade as she continues to scream and scream and scream. We all know that what's happened. We've seen it before. It's a logic virus, a machine weapon that hijacks Android systems and overwrites their data. And since there's no known cure, it's also a death sentence. I need to show her mercy. I need to set her free. My finger rests on the trigger, yet I hesitate, and before I can make that final fateful decision, I hear a voice rise from somewhere behind me. Stop! You can't do this! You can't let your friends die! It's number 21, the girl I thought to be cool and composed beyond all measure, was now pleading with me to spare Lily's life. What do I do? What the hell do I do? Lily said you were like family to her. You can't abandon family. Not before you exhaust every possibility. What can you do then? I'll use my powers to erase the virus. Impossible! Both spat out what we were all thinking of, but before we can act, Lily starts to set nearby comets flying with impossible strength. I've seen infected enters before. I know how much damage they can do once the virus turns off their limiters. They'll fight the fight until they're utterly destroyed. Talia number 16 rushed into the fray, trying to suppress the former friend. But how many of us have been affected now? How many friends have I been forced to put down? The heart I'm not supposed to have aches with the thought. It aches as I remember all of the identification numbers that have been retired. When did I start giving them names? When did I decide I simply couldn't endure it anymore? Initiating reprogramming sequence. The voice number 21? She's screaming something about reprogramming. I don't know what to do. I am lost. As my vision slowly clears, I see number 21 inputting commands into her terminal, while number 2 and number 4 hold her down. They hold her as she writes, and Rose stares at me surprised. Oh, no, I'm holding Lily too. And yeah, that's a beetje like who... De logic virus was vroeger een groot probleem, want ze hadden geen manier om tegen de virus te vechten en zo vroeger. Maar met Yora hebben ze hackers gemaakt die dan wel de virus kunnen, die like echt goed binnen het systeem kunnen komen om de virus te verwijderen.
Interesting. And here we are again.
En nou gaan we naar de laatste gedeelte, de attack on Pearl Harbor.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. By the way.
Moet ik stoppen en eens pauze doen?
3.
Our target is the machine, the server on the Makaala, Mount Kaala, and our situation is dire. We need reinforcement, requesting deployment at once. Number 2 speaks quickly yet calmly, which is all the more remarkable considering the hostile enemy army closing in our position. But the command center is an orbiting satellite informs us no reinforcement will be forthcoming. We are abandoned, we are alone. It's so easy from up there, from the satellite. I'll do whatever is necessary, says Lily, with a grim smile. Talia and Margaret quickly nod in agreement, as does number 16. They decide to join the rear guard, staying behind to be our shield. Even though it comes at the cost of their own lives, regardless, they all agreed without hesitation. For we in the vanguard would be joining them in death soon enough. Without another word, we turn our backs on each other and take up positions. We know this is the end. Talia and the others will buy us time to reach the gate at Kaala's peak. Beyond that lies an elevator, and beyond that is the server. If we can destroy it, we'll deal a devastating blow to the machine life forms throughout the Pacific region. But as I noticed number 21 scowling the elevator, I start to have a bad feeling about the final stage of our mission. Go on, she says, I've got this. We crowd in fear the elevator as Ver begins hacking the terminal. She doesn't need to tell us what's happening. It's clear that the elevator wants to descend all the way to the server unless someone stays behind to control it. Enemies incoming, they are almost on us. As I speak, I suddenly find myself leaping from the elevator and taking up a position at number 21's side. Almost as if my body is out of control. Something's wrong, I'll back up number 21, I cry. The rest of you take out the server. The doors close on my friends. The last thing I see is the face of my Captain Rose. She looks concerned, but then the door's shut and she is no more. That was the last time I ever saw them. But it's alright. I'm going to finish this one way or another. The only sounds we hear are distant explosion and rasp of number 21's breathing. Thank you, she whispers, for staying with me. I look at her eyes and see a telltale red of allergic virus infection. I was right after all. I sigh softly as I draw my weapon. I've seen comrades infected before. That's why I couldn't leave her alone to die alone. The vaccine she gave Lily is already ineffective. The enemy has evolved. They studied number 21's patterns and developed a new resistance. When the elevator reaches the server, begins term 21 weekly, then I'll give you peace, I reply. The elevator moves even lower, creating a countdown on number 21's life. How much time has passed? How much can possibly be left? Too long to wait, yet not long enough. A massive explosion echoes in the distance as the hall slowly shakes. It's the final act of Lily and the others in the rear guard. They've just overloaded their own fusion reactors. The sound of our comrades' demise slowly fades from our ears. As it does number 21, which is up and slowly removes her goggles. I'm glad I got to meet you, she says. Her eyes are so wet, but not completely. There's still a little bit of herself left. And while it is, don't worry. I say I'll be with you. She smiles as my words reach her ears. As soon as the elevator touches down, I fire a bullet in 21's brain. They have brains? I watch the thing out of a tumble to the ground. I set out the gun I hold in tremble my hands. I press it to the bar. My meaningless existence, all of it, it will be finally over. Unforgivable. Your comrades come and sacrifice themselves and fight to the last breath. They feel suffering, they feel sadness, they feel pain and terror. And you, with surrender now, unforgivable. The voice is a battlefield curse, telling those who survive to see their mission through no matter what. Yeah, survivor's guilt, zo'n beetje. I scream at the top of my lungs and race down the hall. I'll show you, if you're going to push me, I'll show you. You'll only be satisfied if there's a bit more killing. I leap into the fray with weapons in both hands. Here I am! Kill me! As I scream, an explosion suddenly rises up and sweeps everything away. A soft wind touches my cheek. I smell fire, I smell ash. The explosion in the server room was powerful enough to take out Mount Kahala itself, reducing it once proud summit to a smoking crater. The machines immediately dropped to the ground and stopped moving. I look over to the scorched earth. Lily, number 16, Rose, number 2. Are any of you? I'm the only one left, the only one. I was alive because I had been afraid to die. I begin to giggle. It's a mad thing, crazy even to my own ears. I'll join you soon. You promised to join her. How could I have said such vain, laughable words, such lies? I laugh, I stand in the smoke and the flame and laugh until I think my very throat started. I blink, daylight drifts through the smoke. I've been standing here all night. My laughter finally depleted. I force myself to my feet. I'm the coward who stayed behind, the coward who lived. Now it's my job to carry on the will of those who fought at my side. Since I can't kill myself, I have to fight until someone does it for me. I'll endure any hardship. I'll kill every machine inside. I'll walk slowly in the west, wrecking them. Hold on. Dus ja, dat was haar achtergrondverhaal.